Hello, I'm Ty Mason from the diabetescouncil.com, researcher, writer, and I have type 2 diabetes. Today I want to talk about the 10 most common home remedies for diabetes and answer the question, do they work? After you watch the video today, I invite you to check out the description box for my new ebook. This is one of the most comprehensive diabetes meal planning books you'll find anywhere. It contains diabetes-friendly meals and recipes, recipes for different goals such as 800 to 1800 calories per day meal plans, diabetes meal planning tips and tricks, and there are also tons of diabetes-friendly recipes for everyone. No matter where you go in every culture, there are those who have home remedies or cures for just about every disease known to man. I am from the South, and I know my family has passed down home remedies from everything from the common cold to snake bites. So I was not shocked to find over 500 home remedies for diabetes with just a quick net search. Now, I've decided to give you the 10 most frequently found, and at the end of the video, I will answer the question, do they work? Number 1, holy basil or tulsi leaves. Now, the leaves of the holy basil plant are packed with antioxidants and essential oils that produce eugenol, methyl eugenol, and caryophyllene. Now, collectively, these compounds help the pancreatic beta cells, cells that store and release insulin. They help them to function properly and increase sensitivity to insulin. An added advantage is the antioxidants present in the leaves help beat the ill effects of oxidative stress. Now, a tip from the net on how to have basil leaves or ingest them, consume 2 or 3 leaves whole or about 1 tablespoonful of its juice on an empty stomach, and it will lower your blood sugar levels. Number 2 on the list, flax seeds or alce. Due to their high fiber content, flax seeds help digestion and aid in the proper absorption of fat and sugars. Consuming flax seeds help to reduce the person with diabetes postprandial sugar level by almost 28%. A tip, you consume 1 tablespoon of ground flaxseed powder every morning on an empty stomach with a glass of warm water. However, you do not have more than 2 tablespoons per day, as it can be detrimental to your health. Number 3, the leaves of the bilberry plant or nilavadari. The leaves of bilberry have been used in Ayurveda for many centuries to control diabetes. Recently, the Journal of Nutrition stated that the leaves of the bilberry plant contain high amounts of anthocyanidin, which enhances the action of various proteins involved in glucose transportation and fat metabolism. Now, due to this unique quality, bilberry leaves are a great way to lower one's blood sugar. You can crush bilberry leaves in a mortar and pestle and consume 100 milligrams of this extract every day, but do so on an empty stomach. Cinnamon, or dalcini. Also known as dalcini, cinnamon improves insulin sensitivity and lower blood glucose levels. Having as little as 1/2 teaspoon of cinnamon per day can improve one's insulin sensitivity and help control weight, thereby decreasing one's risk for heart disease. Include about 1 gram of cinnamon into your daily diet for about a month to help lower blood sugar levels. Number 5, green tea. I found this in a lot of the research I've done. And unlike other tea leaves, green tea is unfermented and is high in polyphenol contents. The polyphenol is a strong antioxidant and hypoglycemic compound that helps control the release of blood sugars and helps the body use insulin even better. Steep a bag of green tea leaves in hot water for 2 to 3 minutes, remove the bag, and drink a cup of this tea in the morning before your meals. Drumstick leaves is number 6. This is also called moringa, and the leaves of this plant are the best known for their ability to boost one's energy. In the case of those with diabetes, the moringa leaf increases satiety and slows the breakdown of food and lower blood pressure. The tip is to take a few drumstick leaves, wash and crush them to extract the juice. Now take 1/4 cup of this juice, drink it on an empty stomach every morning to keep your blood sugar levels under control. Number 7, psyllium husks or isabgol. Psyllium husk is often used as a laxative. When psyllium comes in contact with water, it swells to form a gel-like substance. This slows the breakdown and absorption of blood glucose. Psyllium husk also protects the stomach lining and from ulcers and acidity. You can consume these husks after every meal, ideally with milk or water. Avoid having it with curd as it can lead to constipation. Number 8 is bitter gourd or Corella. Rich in plant insulin, polypeptide B, a biochemical that mimics the insulin produced by the human pancreas and thus reduces sugar levels in the body. It is also known to be highly beneficial for having two very essential compounds called keratin and mamamortisin, which are the key compounds in lowering one's blood sugar. Consume bitter gourd at least twice a week. Try having a glass of bitter gourd juice on an empty stomach once every 3 days. Number 9 is neem. Found abundantly in India, the bitter leaf has a number of amazing medicinal properties. Neem enhances insulin receptor sensitivity, helps improve blood circulation by dilating the blood vessels, lowers blood glucose levels, and reduces one's dependence on hypoglycemic drugs. You can drink the juice of tender shoots of neem leaves on an empty stomach for best results. Number 10, Indian blackberry, or jamun. A glycoside present in the seeds of Indian blackberry prevents the conversion of starch to sugar. It lowers blood sugar and helps prevent insulin spikes. Jambul also has properties that can protect you from heart diseases and other vascular disorders. You can eat 5 or 6 of the Indian blackberries each morning to help control your blood sugar, or you can also add a spoonful of jamun seeds powder to a glass of warm water or milk and drink this daily for better control. Now, those are the 10 that I found, and I gave you what their claims are for diabetes. The following is from the Mayo Clinic. Numerous substances have been shown to improve insulin sensitivity in some studies, while other studies fail to find any benefit for blood sugar control or in lowering A1C levels. Because of the conflicting findings, there aren't any alternative therapies that are currently recommended to help with blood sugar management. If you decide to try an alternative therapy, don't stop taking the medications that your doctor has prescribed. Be sure to discuss the use of any of these therapies with your doctor to make sure they won't cause adverse reactions or interact with your current therapy. Additionally, there are no treatments, alternative or conventional, that can cure diabetes. So it's critical that people who are receiving insulin therapy for diabetes don't stop using insulin unless directed to do so by your physician. So, to answer the question, do they work? No, they do not cure diabetes. Some of them have been shown in some studies to help control blood glucose levels, but I would never take these instead of my diabetes medications. That's my opinion. You can do the research for yourself. But there are plenty of home remedies out there to look at. The 10 I've given you are the 10 most popular ones that I've found throughout not just the U.S., but throughout the world, actually. I invite you to check out my research. See if you find the same results that I did. Again, the question was, do these home remedies work to cure diabetes or as an alternative to medications? I say no, they are not. The properties that some of them show have been studied in research, but none of that research has been overwhelmingly accepted by the scientific community. And, you know, my research is based on science and science alone. If any of these had been researched to the point to say, hey, you can take this instead of metformin or this instead of insulin, and it was proven by a scientific research method, I'd be the first to tell you, hey, give it a try. But none of these have been shown in any way, shape, form, or fashion to cure diabetes. There is no cure for diabetes. There are a lot of shysters out there that will tell you they have the cure. And I just invite you to please, please, please research them very carefully. Because, folks, there is no cure for the disease that we have. Don't forget to get my new ebook, like this video, and subscribe to our channel so we can continue to bring you informative videos like this one in the future. I want to thank you so much for watching. I'm Ty Mason.